We are the people. We are the power. We are the 99%.
On our right hand side, think to yourselves, where will my job be in 10 years' time? What is the future for my children and my grandchildren beyond that? When they ask us, what did we do in the year 2020? Are you going to be able to stand up and say that you knew all of the information? Are you going to be able to stand up and say that you trusted the people in charge?
One thing I like to do is when I look into my child's eyes, I like to know that I'm the future.
And answers it. What is happening in Liverpool right now? They're saying no. Never underestimate the power of the smallest word, N-O, no. Do you know why they went for Liverpool first? Do you want to know why? In the days of the plantation, the slave master, when he wants to break the slaves, do you know what he does? He goes for the biggest, strongest one first. And he breaks them in front of all of the other slaves. With Scousers and militant people, they haven't got that reputation for nothing. Thank you to the Scousers for saying no. Because I hate to say it. I'm a Southerner born and bred. I hate to say it. If they tried that down here, I'm not sure we would have said no. But now, Liverpool have set the example.
Tracy, who is the owner of Le Munch, I'm just going to ask a few questions with what's happened with her and the lockdown and some of the pressure the council have been putting on. So Tracy, so I hear that you stayed open during lockdown?
That's correct.
Yeah. And, sorry.
Yeah, we stayed open. We left all our chairs outside and we were still allowing people to eat. Not inside, but outside. And there was at least 2 metres distance, but unfortunately the council were coming down asking us to bring our chairs in, to which we just kept putting them back out again. And we managed to stay open, but we did that because we diversified the business over to people delivering. People still coming in, collecting. What we also did was we moved a lot of the stuff around in the cafe and opened up as a shop. So our locals are still getting.
Oh, so yeah, they said pick up some deliveries.
Yeah, well that, but also supplying food at the time. You couldn't get toilet roll, you couldn't get eggs, or couldn't get potatoes. So we went out of all those necessities for local people, and also delivered some of the people that couldn't get out. Oh. So we kind of diversified a little bit in order to keep the shop open, yeah. Yeah.
Okay. Okay, your custom actually went up as a result as well.
Yeah. We did quite well, deliveries, and once people knew we were selling products and still open, yeah. We got a lot of business, because I think unfortunately so many people closed down, and there's still people that need to, well, a few people were still working, loads of people still need to somewhere to go, so
yeah,
we filled in that gap, that service there. Yeah, and as a result, a lot of businesses didn't come back from that.
Okay, and do you think it's something that businesses could possibly follow your sort of...
I think that if people choose to close their businesses down, that they have to realise that they may not have a business to come back to. Because if everyone says no, and we remain with our businesses open, and continue as usual, then they've saved their businesses. But if you close your business down, don't expect it to be there in a few months. Because we probably will have another lockdown, won't we?
Yeah,
and then, if everyone says no, what can they do? We all stand together. There's nothing they can do.
Totally
so I encourage everybody to
I totally agree. Yeah. And just to confirm, you haven't had any fines or anything like that?
No fines, no. I had a few reports from some local people that were not too happy. But as a whole, again, business gone up because people are aware now that we're not wearing masks. We're not tracking and tracing. I can't enforce that. I've got a sign on the door, but I'm not being paid to... And I wouldn't do it anyway to force somebody. So that is everyone's choice, isn't it? If they want
to
share. No, you shouldn't be forced to do anything. Nobody should be forced to close everything down. It's illegal what the government are doing, and people need to wake up now. They've had long enough to think about it, and they need to stand together, and they need to just say no and go about their normal lives. And, you know, as a result of that, that's the only way we're going to get back on track. When this country's never going to get back on track if we just continue to follow rules. Because okay. Boris is just going to bankrupt the country. It's going to be a global crash, yeah. A depression.
Totally agree.
Yeah.
Yes, if we take the same way, it's going to be longer.
Yeah, we don't know which way that is.
Totally agree.
So, thank you, Tracy. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.